Thanks for joining us here online. I'm Adam Sexton with a look at the stories we're following this afternoon. Updating the breaking news out of Exeter, the emergency department and operating rooms at Exeter Hospital have been evacuated. Around 11:15 this morning, staff and patients started complaining of dizziness and nausea. About 20 people are affected. Ambulances from across the seacoast were called to help and evaluate and transfer patients. We don't yet know the source of the odor that has sickened them. The rest of the hospital is not affected. We will, of course, bring you the latest all afternoon here on WMUR.com and on our mobile app, and live team coverage starting on News 9 at 5. State of addiction coverage this afternoon. President Trump announcing new steps in the fight against the opioid crisis. The president is now calling the drug epidemic a national emergency, and he is vowing to dedicate federal time and money to fighting the crisis. This declaration could mean more resources for New Hampshire. A Pelham man has admitted he had fentanyl in his possession when police arrived at his house to arrest him, and that he warned officers about the danger. As of right now, Thomas Reagan is charged with selling heroin. WMUR's Ray Brewer is outside court, where we learned those charges will soon change.
As the prosecution asked that bail be set at $100,000 cash, Thomas Reagan stared in disbelief.
We're basing this upon, basically, first off, an extreme danger to the public here.
Reagan was one of two people arrested Thursday after an investigation began last week into Reagan allegedly selling heroin out of his home on Pine Ridge Road in Pelham. He's charged with three felonies for allegedly selling heroin, but the prosecution says it was actually something deadlier.
That he was selling straight fentanyl in these packages of alleged heroin.
Although he was cautioned against speaking out about the facts, Reagan admitted to possessing the drug.
And I know it is fentanyl because I am on the methadone clinic, and I do get drug tested and occasionally use, and that has so happened to be one of the days I was occasionally using, sir.
In asking that his bail be lowered, Reagan said he told the officers fentanyl was in his home, so the officers would take proper precautions, which the prosecutor corroborated.
He even went so far as to stop my officers before entering to warn them because of the amount of fentanyl in his kitchen on the table, I believe.
But the prosecutor told the court that in no way mitigates the charges against Reagan and the threat his actions pose to Pelham and surrounding communities.
Fentanyl is extremely dangerous to the public, to anyone who comes within even just breathing range of it. And due to the fact that this person would have this in our community and be selling it, just at large, is an extreme danger to the public.
That was Ray Brewer reporting. A Concord woman is now facing multiple charges after police say she tried to rob a man in a wheelchair in Manchester. Just before noon yesterday, police say Michelle Millardo offered the man sexual favors for cash. When he refused, she tried to rip a gold chain from his neck and run away. Several people rushed to his aid after the man yelled for help and held Millardo down until police arrived. Manchester police have made a quick arrest after a robbery at a convenience store on Mammoth Road. Investigators say 23-year-old Dakota Clifford robbed the store just before 9:30 last night. He was arrested a short time later on Knowlton Road. Clifford is also charged with violation of bail. Investigators are trying to track down a boater who crashed into two tubers on Lake Winnipesaukee in Alton. The teens were thrown from their inner tube when another boat slammed into them Tuesday night. One was taken to the hospital. The boat that hit them is described as white with blue or gray lettering. Once again, stay with us here on WMUR.com all afternoon for the very latest on the situation at Exeter Hospital. For now, I'm Adam Sexton. Have a great day.